So continuing on, we've covered off Ohm's law of equals IR and Kirchhoff's voltage law, which is the sum of the currents around, sorry, the sum of the voltages around a closed loop equals zero. And we've also mentioned a diode, in this case here, a silicon diode, which has a 0.7 volt drop, which then in a circuit you can accommodate using Kirchhoff's voltage laws to understand what are the voltages at other points in the circuit. So another configuration that we often run into with circuit design is we call it a voltage divider. And we use the voltage divider to create a voltage at some point in a circuit so that we can establish a bias point, an operating point around which the rest of the circuit works. So let's go back to our battery design here again. And a voltage divider looks like this. And the essence of it is, what is, this is our voltmeter, what is the voltage at this point that we're trying to set up? So let's just clean the circuit up. So it is truly closed, so the electrons don't have trouble transferring across through the circuit. Let's take a voltage, how about 10 volts? And let's take two resistors. How about 8K ohms? And in this case here, R2, I could make this 12K ohms, just for numbers. So let's call this resistor 2 and this resistor 1. Okay, so we know that looking at this, so 12 and 8 is 20K. Again, Ohm's law, I equals V over R. So if we have 10 volts divided by 20,000 ohms, what we have is 0.5 milliamps of current in the circuit. Now, if that is the case, then what is the voltage here? Well, let's write some equations down. So we know that V source is equal to I times R1 plus I times R2. Okay, the voltage that drops across the entire circuit is that. We could have constructed Kirchhoff's laws and equal to zero and take the 10 across like that. But basically, that's the numbers. And that, let's just clean that up a little bit. That's I times brackets R1 plus R2. So that in this case here, let me isolate my I, my current. It's equal to V source. So we're taking this from multiplying to this side where you were dividing over R1 plus R2. Okay. Now, what is this voltage here which we're really trying to establish? Well, basically, it is the voltage at R2 is equal to the current through here, same current flows through this entire circuit, is the current through R2 times, sorry, the current through R2 times R2. So that's that. So we have this equation, we have I here, and we have I here. Why don't I substitute this I for this I? So what I've got is VR2 equals VS over R1 plus R2 times R2. This is the classic, well, it's like saying this is the total pi. I'm taking a piece of that pi. But this is the formula that people use all the time. Rather than calculating currents, resistances, voltage drop, subtract the voltage drop across here from the source, you can just use this formula. VR2 equals the source voltage times this particular resistor, R2, divided by R1 plus R2. And please keep in mind, brackets are important because if you don't use them on your calculator, you will probably make an error in the order. Remember bed mass, brackets, exponents, multiply, divide, add, subtract, in the order of your calculations. So again, just voltage divider, and this is going to be used all the way up to your final semester in your designs, is simply this resistance over the total resistance times the source voltage will give you the voltage across that particular point. Thanks.